Today, I'm going to show you every single LEGO Star Wars game I could find in existence. No, I'm not only talking about the giant releases. I'm going to try to show you some stuff you've never seen before. LEGO Star Wars games have a rich history, dating all the way back to 2005. And I guarantee there are more than you realize. So let's do it. This is the evolution of LEGO Star Wars games. Hey everyone, it's Andrew. Off with the first LEGO Star Wars video game ever made. LEGO Star Wars The Video Game. The year was 2005, and newly formed TT Games just created the game that would define their company for the next 17 years. A game changer. They literally made the same game over and over again and just made it better and better. So LEGO Star Wars The Video Game released a few months before Revenge of the Sith and was an immediate success, a bestseller. You could play through each of the prequel films and Dex's Diner was used as the hub world. How you doing, Dex? Good to see you there. And there were LEGO games made before this, but nothing like this, nothing on this scale. This game had 59 playable characters, it had different worlds, missions. I had the game on PS2, and this is really where it all started. And as a little tease of TT Games' next game, LEGO Star Wars 1 also had this as a bonus mission. And there was also a separate version of LEGO Star Wars The Video Game developed for the Game Boy Advance, which is basically a shorter, much simpler version of the full game. It also skipped a lot of missions from the console version. For example, in Attack of the Clones, they don't even go to Kamino. You don't even go there, they completely skip it. And there's no arena battle on Geonosis, it's gone. Obi-Wan somehow just escaped on his own.
Somehow Palpatine returned.
For some reason, they also didn't update a lot of the character models in this game. In Revenge of the Sith, you play as episode 2 Anakin and episode 1 Obi-Wan. Like, what? You're literally fighting as a Padawan. Platforming also insanely difficult in this version. Oh, and most cutscenes are literally just still images. Back in 2005, this was cutting edge for a handheld device. And another huge difference to the console version, there was no hub world. So only a year after LEGO Star Wars The Video Game released, in 2006, TT Games created LEGO Star Wars 2, the original trilogy. And this game took everything laid down by the first and brought to life the original trilogy in LEGO form. Instead of Dex's Diner, we now have the Cantina as the hub world. 114 playable characters if you carried over the ones from the previous game using your save files. And this game was already becoming larger than the original, giving us another taste of that now classic, tongue-in-cheek LEGO humor. We'd never really seen the Star Wars films parodied like this, and now there was one for the original trilogy. And LEGO Star Wars 2 The Original Trilogy also released a version of the game for Game Boy Advance and Nintendo DS, both of which were actually different from one another. The Game Boy version was a lot similar to the previous game, LEGO Star Wars 1, but the DS version took handheld LEGO gaming to another level, featuring a hub world and gameplay that was closer to the console version, so you could basically take the console version with you on the Nintendo DS now. Impressive stuff. Now, LEGO Star Wars 2 also had a PSP version, which was also slightly different from all the others. This version didn't have any of the bounty hunter missions from the main game, and instead had the final boss fights from the original game, including Darth Maul, Count Dooku, and Darth Vader, aka Anakin, from LEGO Star Wars 1. They were here, you could play them in this game. Just the PSP version. Why so many different random versions back then? In 2007, something very special happened. TT Games had a genius idea. What if we take LEGO Star Wars the video game and LEGO Star Wars 2, the original trilogy, and put them together? This is LEGO Star Wars The Complete Saga. What an amazing idea, with a total of 128 characters, Gonk Droid included. This is still arguably the best ultimate LEGO Star Wars experience. Featuring an expanded hub world in the Mos Eisley Cantina, you can now play through both the prequel and original trilogy, combining characters in free play for your own wild LEGO adventure. The Complete Saga also had 6 bonus missions and several rare unlockable characters you could buy from the menu. Now, LEGO Star Wars The Complete Saga had an entirely different version for the Nintendo DS, just like the previous games. This one featured a more simplified hub world and different cutscenes, mostly based on those in the original game, but in some cases, way more violent. Oh my gosh, it's Count Dooku's head. They showed it in the film and they showed it here. This is only in this version, only on the DS. The DS, which is meant for younger kids. That's the one they decided to put Dooku's head flying across the screen in. Lego games, man. They get away with so much violence just because it's Lego. Look at how brutal this is. In 2009, a 5-minute short called Lego Star Wars The Quest for R2-D2 was released on Cartoon Network. And along with it, a game with the same name, Lego Star Wars The Quest for R2-D2, a free online game developed in the Unity engine, originally playable on Lego.com. You could choose to play as either Anakin Skywalker or Asajj Ventress, for either the light or dark side, and would make your way through levels collecting crystals, destroying battle droids, and trying to unlock Obi-Wan Kenobi and Count Dooku so you could play through the same levels again, just as them. Pretty sure that's all you could do. You could jump, you could force push, you could swing your lightsaber, and even enter cheat codes. Anyway, so I just watched through the 5-minute Cartoon Network short, and the game feels like it has literally nothing to do with it, apart from the fact that you play as Anakin and everything Star Wars. It's literally completely... They go to so many different planets in the short. This one, you're just walking around some corridors. In 2011, TT Games released their next big LEGO game, their biggest at this time, LEGO Star Wars 3 The Clone Wars, which took what was done in the original games and the complete saga to another level. Massive, large-scale battles with hundreds of enemies. And that was one of the unique features of this game, the scale. Look how many characters are on screen at once. It's 2011. The game came with 115 playable characters and was entirely focused on the Clone Wars film and TV series, which was still running at the time. Although there were also some classic unlockable characters like Luke and his daddy Vader. How you doing, daddy?
Yo, dudes.
Lightsaber mechanics had also evolved quite a bit since the complete saga, with faster, more fluid movements, as well as improved force abilities, more complex puzzles, and so much more. LEGO Star Wars 3 also released as a handheld version, with the DS, 3DS, and PSP games all being slightly different from one another. On these devices, the game was less impressive than the console versions, but mostly followed the same missions. For a lot of people, I've noticed LEGO Star Wars 3 The Clone Wars is their favorite LEGO game ever made because of its focus on the Clone Wars and unique large-scale battles. And still to this day, it's never really been done again. Just gotta learn how to destroy the giant golden things. It's so hard! In 2013, we had the release of one of my favorite LEGO Star Wars games ever made. LEGO Star Wars Advent Calendar. Yes, that's the name of the game. You play as Jango Fett, and it's your job to platform your way through these levels, delivering gifts for Life Day. Jango's given up his bounty hunting ways. He knew it was going to end with him losing his head. So instead, he put on some red pants and began spreading Life Day cheer. Pretty sure back when this game released, there were also a bunch of codes you could get from the LEGO Star Wars Advent Calendar packs, which you could use to unlock characters in the game. And overall, it's really solid as a web game. Gameplay is challenging, satisfying, but most importantly, addictive. I played this thing for hours and left it open in a different tab, come back to it day after day, in between doing other stuff, working, trying to work. No, I just gotta play LEGO Star Wars Advent Calendar. And it's actually really hard. I still have never finished this game. LEGO Star Wars The Yoda Chronicles was also released in 2013, alongside the animated series.
Answering your call for help, we are.
I didn't call for help.
I'm on vacation down here.
This was a mobile and web game set during the Clone Wars and allowed you to play as either light or dark side characters like Yoda and Count Dooku. There were 15 different levels, over 30 minifigures, and similar to LEGO Star Wars 3, you could spawn in groups of clones and vehicles and control them in battle. A lot of Clone Wars themed stuff happening back in the early 2010s. In 2014, we had the release of LEGO Star Wars Microfighters. Ah yes, a mobile game where you choose one of 6 different microfighters and fly through different tracks collecting LEGO studs. And that's basically it. I downloaded this game a few years back on my iPhone and deleted it the next day because it gets old real quick. Kind of a micro game, if you know what I mean. There's not much going on here. You drive through the track, that's about all there is to it. Look at this epic gameplay. This is LEGO Star Wars Ultimate Rebel, released in 2014. A top-down web game where you pilot a bunch of different vehicles and make your way through levels destroying enemies. The objective of each level is to find keys to open certain doors and make your way to the exit without being killed. Now, you might have heard of LEGO Star Wars The Yoda Chronicles, but why play that when you can play LEGO Star Wars The New Yoda Chronicles?
We don't serve droids here.
I am not a droid.
This is a mobile game that was also available on the LEGO website. It had a bunch of mini games. You could fly starfighters, play as Yoda, but unfortunately you can't do any of that anymore because it was removed from the App Store several years back. As is the case with most Star Wars mobile games. Bring back Tiny Death Star! LEGO Star Wars Empire vs. Rebels was kind of like a less impressive sequel to LEGO Star Wars Advent Calendar. It had platforming, puzzle solving, but no Jango Fett dressed as Santa Claus, therefore it's significantly inferior. This is LEGO Star Wars Force Builder, released in 2015. A game all about using the Force to build your own starfighters and ships. You could select different colors and parts to build your ship, and then fly through a course. And that was pretty much it. Again, the microfighters and starship games really aren't cutting it. Also, you can't play this one anymore because it no longer exists. They removed it from everywhere. LEGO Star Wars The Force Awakens was, at the time, TT Games' largest LEGO Star Wars game ever made. It released in 2016, nearly a year after the actual film, and began with a few levels from Return of the Jedi in the prologue. Wait, that's young Anakin, what? Ah, yes, the classic LEGO humor. This game had over 204 playable characters, most of who are voiced by the actual cast members from the films. There's Daisy Ridley, John Boyega, Oscar Isaac, Adam Driver, they're all here, even Carrie Fisher and Harrison Ford. This game also introduced new mechanics like multi-builds, the ability to build multiple objects from the same pieces. There was a cover system, you could travel to different planets and explore the hub worlds. It's funny because a lot of people prefer the complete saga and the Clone Wars over this game, but when you look at it, it's actually quite impressive. There's a lot going on here. In 2016 and 2017, there were two newer, separate versions of LEGO Star Wars Empire vs. Rebels released. Web browser platforming side-scrollers with puzzle-solving elements. Still nothing as good as Jango Fett and his Red Santa suit. Does anyone have the minifigure, please? Send it to me. I want it! Next, we are jumping all the way to 2020. There were a few years there when no LEGO Star Wars games released at all. This is one of my favorite LEGO Star Wars games in recent years. LEGO Star Wars Battles, a mobile tower defense-style game where you'd face off against other players, spawn in units, and try to destroy their towers. Each match lasts for about 2.5 minutes, and in that time you need to either have destroyed your enemy's base or have them completely overrun to get the victory. Now, this game had a bit of a strange history. It was announced in 2019, released in 2020 for only selected regions, and at this point the game wasn't actually finished, it was still in beta, and then in June 2021 they cancelled it and removed it from the app stores. You couldn't download it anymore. I mean, I don't think I could even download it in my country. I think I used it. I found it somewhere else. But then in late 2021, it resurfaced on Apple Arcade and you can play it now there. Great game, and I'm glad it got revived. Now, apart from LEGO Star Wars Battles, which was technically released in 2020, 2021 only had one LEGO Star Wars game. The Skywalker Saga had just been delayed, but we did get this. LEGO Star Wars Castaways. So in this game, you customize your own character, get stranded on some tropical island, and go around talking to the island residents, discovering secrets, leveling up to unlock lightsabers, weapons, we've got limbs flying everywhere, and play through events based on the films, and even participate in illegal street racing. Just gonna steal that guy's ride. Okay, dude, see you later. There are also a bunch of side missions which help you level up and unlock more gear. And honestly, a lot of elements here are similar to the Skywalker Saga. Oh, and you can also level up to unlock Force Lightning and become an all-out Sith Lord. Oh, jeez. Oh, wow. It's lots of fun. Played this thing for hours and hours. There's lots to do. Lots of great game. All right, it's time. The magnum opus of LEGO Star Wars games. In 2022, we have LEGO Star Wars The Skywalker Saga. Finally, after 3 years of waiting. From the first trailer, it was clear this game was going to be bigger and better than anything that had come before. Before making this, TT Games even considered remastering or remaking the complete saga, but then they were like, nah, why would we do that when we can make this? All 9 films, 23 planets, side missions, over 300 characters. Sadly, no character customization at this point, but man, this is one massive Star Wars game. Open world. What I think is so impressive about the Skywalker Saga, on top of all this, is that there's something to notice and discover almost anywhere you go. The detail, the animations, graphics, character models, the realism, the humor, mumble mode as an option. It truly is the ultimate LEGO Star Wars game, and there may never be another like it. What's your favorite LEGO Star Wars game of all time? I'd love to hear your thoughts in the comments. And if you're new around here, I also have a clips channel with daily clips, memes, LEGO stuff over there. Make lots of LEGO videos. You can come check one of those out here. And also, follow me on Instagram, Twitter, join my Discord, and my TikTok for lots more LEGO content and to stay up to date with me and news. And thanks for watching this. My name's Andrew. I'll catch you soon.
Stay bombastic.